Hi, thanks for tuning in. Today, hi Helios. Today we're coming live from our bathroom. Because of this little guy right here, none of the cats want to be on camera today. They're like, we're in the front scene, we're in the very first scene, we're out of here. Zeus is gonna rub his face on the tripod, so if you see it moving, that tells you why. So we're here because of this guy. If you watch my other videos, you saw where I talked about getting the open air because Zeus wouldn't use it. Well, I've discovered, and I mentioned it in a couple of the videos, he's really marking the tripod. I can see it moving. Helios, Zeus! So I always mix up. I've been chasing the cats down, so I'm like sweating. Plus there's no air in here, and it was a hot day today here in Utah, and this house is old, so it retains the heat. Helios. So basically, I discovered it was this guy. I thought it was Zeus not using the litter robot, and that's why I got the open air. And now I'm covered in Helios's hair. But what I've discovered is, since then, you know, I saw Zeus use the litter robot before we got the open air. He used a smaller one. And then I caught this guy going outside of the litter robot. I had removed all the litter boxes. And so this guy left me a present. And so I'm wondering, I thought maybe he was just scared of the litter robot, of the noise it made. Because he wasn't raised with it. I had him in a separate room where I used to live. He had a litter box. Zeus and Phoebe were somewhere else with the litter robot. He had a regular litter box, a traditional scooping litter box. And he didn't see the litter robot too until we moved in here. And what I've since discovered, I've seen this in the past, but I just discovered it yesterday, is that big old mean Zeus, who's jealous of this guy, Mr. Helios, Zeus is being a bully. He's on the floor right there. So Zeus, it's funny, all the cats moved off camera. They're all down there watching us. We have a live audience today in our bathroom. And Mr. Helios wants down too. Meow. So poor Mr. Helios here, even though he's a big, tough tomcat with claws, he's intact, he could kick Zeus's butt. He could really fight him. I mean, seriously, do some injuries. But he's just a poor little scaredy cat because he was introduced to Zeus when Zeus was mean and Helios was a tiny little kitten. And I did keep them separated, but then they were back together when Helios got bigger. So Zeus had Helios cornered in the bedroom where the bed goes up against the wall. And poor Helios was cowering on the ground like submissive. He was all scared. And I walked in and saw that and I yelled at Zeus. Helios took off, and I didn't yell that loud. I just said, Zeus! And I've talked to Zeus, I've told him to be nice, and I made him sit there and listen to me and look at me. And he does understand it, because he used to chase him, and he's backed off. He doesn't do it in front of me now. He knows I don't want him being mean to these kitties. But because Helios won't go in the litter robot, and I figured it out, it's a dead end. The litter robot has one entrance and one exit. He's cornered. If he goes in there, and he's probably gone in there in the past, in the old one, and here's Athena, and Zeus has probably attacked him. I've seen Phoebe do it to others. She could have did it him too. So Helios is scared to use the litter robot because it's a dead end. It's probably too much to ask for a litter robot that has two doors. You know, to keep the litter would probably spill out. But this poor little guy won't use it. I'm tired of having a scooping litter box with little presents and smells. He's an intact tomcat. He does not spray. Knock on wood, I don't want to jinx myself. He's a really good guy. He does everything in the litter box. He doesn't spray anywhere, and he doesn't go outside. Zeus was a different story when he's growing up, but I stopped Zeus from spraying inside after I neutered him. We had a little discussion a couple times, and he decided he didn't want to spray inside. And I used to let him out, and he would spray in the backyard, but go in the house and do nothing. This guy here, he's never been outside. He's never been in cat fights other than probably Zeus or Phoebe, but not with serious tomcats. So he's good. He does it in his litter box, and it stinks. The musk smell of the tomcat wakes me up in the middle of the night gagging. And you see I have kids and pets right here. Kids and pets removes the odor, but really all you have to do is cover it. He won't bury either. He used to do it off and on, but he won't bury it. And that may be his instinctual his instincts saying, you know, leave it uncovered because he's marking his territory. So I don't blame that on him. Helios, stay here. So with this guy here, he does that little stinky smell in the middle of the night, and I get up because I can't stand smelling it, and I cover it. I get a scoop of litter, and I just cover it up and go back to sleep. But he is a good kitty, poor little guy. He's just picked on. I wish he wasn't scared. He's a tough guy. He's a big cat. So I have a solution for Mr. Helios here. And that's what you've been waiting for. You've seen the title, so you know what we're going to talk about. So I got this. Came Priority. They just slapped a label on it, shipped it to my P.O. box. That's the P.O. box that's listed on my, should be on YouTube, but it's also on Facebook, some other pages where people can send me stuff. So, you know, I'm not worried about that. But I got the Shitty Kitty Cat the CitiKitty Cat Toilet Training Kit. So we're going to try this with, oh, when he's using the litter. He's doing it right now. I just cleaned out that litter box because I wanted him to do this. And I wanted him to do it first, but he's real nervous with all the cats in here and the door shut. So he's doing something in the litter box that's going to stink really bad here in another minute. So let's open this thing up and get it going. I wanted him to do, next time he had to go to the bathroom, I wanted him to go on this. But obviously, that's not going to work. So let's open up our Shitty Kitty toilet training kit. Ooh, these are very nasty. These are from when I had roses. When I would prune roses at one place when I was doing a lot of landscaping. Those are extremely sharp and pointy. So here is our little kit. Oh, I guess it just punches out. I was wondering how they would do this. I guess you can just punch these out. But it talks about going backwards if you have to, like removing these and then putting them back in. So I wonder how that works, because this is just plastic. It's thin plastic, and if you punch a hole in it, how's it going to stay again? Well, oh, there's a video on it too, probably online, I believe there is one. Let's see what else we got. So we got, a little quick card, little quick tips there. So it's got a picture of their cat, and here it says, quick tips. I don't know if that's going to focus, I'm kind of far away. So this is, every cat's unique, train them at their different speeds, reward and praise, keep the toilet lit up, do not disturb. Cats like privacy in the bathroom just like people do. That's a lie! When I had the little robot in the bathroom here, because there's enough room for it, when I came in to sit on the toilet, which I'm sitting on right now, but I'm not doing anything, my pants are up. TMI, I know. What do you, see my little catnip in there? When I came in and used the bathroom in the past, when I had the litter robot in here, all these cats would come in and use it. When I first moved in here, I had a giant litter box, a normal one right here. And when Athena, as a tiny kitten, came in and sat at one edge, and the litter box goes this way, lengthwise, Athena sat on the edge by me facing that way. So the rest of the litter box was open. Zeus came in, sat next to her, facing the same direction, and they were both right in front of me using the litter box. So this saying cats want privacy, no. I've had cats for too long, no. And I left my phone upstairs that day, so I couldn't take a picture of them with my camera phone, with my cell phone. Oh man, he just did a big urine mess in there. It smells. Oh man. There's no litter in there either. Oh, this is almost empty. Helios, you stink. This is supposed to get rid of instant stain odor remover. So basically, oh man, it's male cat musk scent marking odor. So it says here, cats do not disturb, yeah, whatever. Keep it clean. So you gotta clean the seat after each use. And proceed when your cat is ready, take smaller steps. It's designed so it can be modified. Feel free to remove 1/4 or 1/2 of a ring at a time. Have confidence. Make changes when you are around. Move on to a new training step when you are around for encouragement. Example, on weekends. This enables you to see how your cat is adapting and give support if needed. 10. Kitties love catnip. Duh. Oh, sorry, Helios. You okay? Alright, so that's it for the Shitty Kitty box. Here's the catnip we got, Melvis' a stash of catnip. And here's the toilet training guide. I'm going to potty train my kitties. Preparing your bathroom. Oh, secure the lid up. Hey, I didn't think about doing that. Oh, look at Phoebe. She wants the catnip. No! Yeah, this is saying put tape on there to keep the lid up so it doesn't fall on the cat because, yeah, that would scare Helios big time. That's a good idea. Tape the lid up. And I can leave it up. I don't need to put the lid down. They have their water out there. They don't drink out of the bowl. Store cat treats in close proximity to the toilet so you can reward them. Keep a small trash can handy. I have a trash can right there. I have trash bags. Remove area rugs from your bathroom so you can easily keep it clean. Yeah, because this guy will go on the rugs. He's done it in here, not out there. And that's when I removed the litter boxes and all that was left was Litter Robot. He came in here and did it. So he's a good kitty. It's just that stinker Zeus that's sitting on the floor right down there was being a bully. All right, so remove your cat's litter box, replace it with the shitty kitty training seat. Has little pictures here showing how to do it. And it's got little paw prints in there. Introduce your cat to the training seat by gently placing your cat in the center. Oh, that's the paws on the litter. That's a good way to get kicked in the face with litter. You got a picture of Indy dumping a load on the toilet there. Seat will flex slightly when your cat hops on it. The flex in the seat encourages your cat to use the toilet seat for support. Okay. Yeah, with these big guys, I hope they don't fall through. This says it handles cats up to 25 pounds. So Zeus is roughly 18, and this guy was 12 under a year of age. I haven't weighed him since. He could easily weigh 14. All right, so it's got little instructions how to remove it. It says remove it gently, blah, blah, blah. Shows them like with a butter knife, a picture of a hand with a butter knife cutting out the pieces. And is that it? Step two, step three, step four. Oh, eventually you get down to nothing and it's gone. Keep the empty training seat on the toilet for a week and then remove it when your cat's ready. Multiple cats. I have multiple cats. It'd be awesome if all four of them used this constantly. I'd probably keep the open air as a backup. And they were at first only using the open air litter robot, but I've since seen Phoebe using the litter robot too. I think because the other one wasn't cycling, so I moved it to 3 minutes so it would cycle faster. But I told my brother I'd give him the litter robot too because he has three cats and they've been scooping by hand forever. All right, so I'm gonna try not to block the camera from the toilet. Little Athena is excited to use it. Oh, you're gonna sit here right when we're filming? Oh, baby kitty, you gotta get down. All right, so it says it fits elongated toilets, which I have, and it pretty much fits. Yeah, it's right there, it's just not covering the back, that's okay. So, yeah. It's fitting, it's right here, it's not quite, it's more up in this area. Okay. So can you see that good? Let's come over and look at it. So here's the shitty kitty on the toilet. Yeah, Phoebe. So I just lifted this up and set it on there. And there it is, City Kitty. All right, so let's get some litter. And so this is the litter I chose. Not really one that I wanted to use, but it's only one that's round and convenient. Claims it's flushable. Right there, it says it's flushable. World's best cat litter, I guess. Let's put some in. All right, kitties, watch out. I don't want to poke you in the eye with this. Back up, everyone. They think they're getting fed. It says it holds, well, let's see, this will sit on the seat. Whenever they hear a wrinkled bag like this, they think it's food. And they have food outside, out in the house. Okay, so let me put this away because this is dangerously sharp. These things are razor sharp. Move, kitties. All right. And I left the scoop outside. So this is supposed to be corn, I believe. They said it's corn. So let's put some in here. Smells like grain. Smells like cereal, like granola or something, like grape nuts. If you know what grape nuts are. All right. So since everything's clean and sterile to begin with, I don't mind using my hands. Of course, after the fact is gonna be gloves and a scoop. Okay. This is gonna be fun when I gotta go to the bathroom in the morning in a hurry. And I gotta pee. I didn't even think about that. I only have one toilet. I'm gonna be in a hurry to dump a load or urinate in the morning, and guess what's gonna be in my way? This will be interesting. Okay. And I need to get a scoop for this one as well. I don't want to cross-contaminate the litter, so I'm gonna get a different scoop for this one. Okay. All right, so that looks pretty good. Let's see what the cats think of it. Helios, go check out your new toilet. Helios. No, that's not your toilet. He's looking at the litter box here. Come here. Check out your new toilet. Look at that. I wish I would have had that ready for you. Okay. Helios, look at the camera. Look. Meow. All right. Well, we'll keep updating you with Helios's progress and see if the other cats will use it as well. Thanks for tuning in. Give us a couple paws up. Share with everyone. Thanks again. Purr, Zeusy, purr.